After installing PI DataLink, it's possible that the PI DataLink ribbon shown up here will not appear. In this video, we're going to cover a couple common causes and solutions for this problem. So in the first case, maybe the PI DataLink add-in was disabled. This can happen during an Excel crash. To check, we'll look in Excel options and then add-ins. In a healthy PI DataLink installation, we'll see the Excel and the COM add-in here at the top. If you're missing the COM add-in, come down here to the drop-down and select COM add-ins and go. In a healthy DataLink installation, this box will be present and checked. If your add-in is disabled, though, this box will be unchecked. And while it may appear that checking it and hitting OK works, when you come back in to the COM add-ins, it'll be unchecked again. If that's the case, it's possible that the PI DataLink COM add-in has been disabled. To check if it's disabled, come down here to the disabled items this time and hit go. If PI DataLink appears in this list, select it and click enable. After that, you may need to re-add the PI DataLink in the COM add-ins. And after that, your ribbon should appear. Another reason why the DataLink ribbon may not show up is actually due to an Office 2010 installation issue. During Office 2010, and only in Office 2010, an issue may occur during the automatic setup of the primary interop assemblies. To see if this issue is currently affecting you, first, verify that the ribbon is in fact missing. If you go into the Options, Add-ins, you'll see no active application add-ins. Open up the Control Panel. Select either Programs and Features or Uninstall a Program. Select Office Professional Plus 2010 and select the Change button at the top. Don't select Uninstall, but select Change. Select Add or Remove Features, the top option. Expand out Microsoft Excel, and you'll see that there's an X next to .NET Programmability Support. Select Run from My Computer and hit the Continue button. This will install the Microsoft Primary Interop Assemblies for 2010, which come bundled in the installation kit for Office 2010. Now that you've completed the installation of the Primary Interop Assemblies, you're not done yet. Open up Excel. You still don't see the ribbon. Come into the File Options menu. Select Add-ins. Select the COM add-ins. The Go button, and select the DataLink add-in. After you've done this, you should now see the PI ribbon, and it should be functional. Another issue that can occur when installing PI DataLink has to do with the administrative privileges, or the privileges when you actually install the program. If you don't install it as an administrator, it will not write the necessary things to the registry, and you won't see the ribbon. First, let's open up Excel and check to see if the ribbon is there. In our case, no, it is not. So to check to see if this is an issue that's affecting us, let's open up the Start menu and go to the Registry Editor. Type in REGEDIT and open up the Registry Editor. First place we'll look for the key is under HKEY Local Machine Software. If you're on a 32-bit machine, just go to Microsoft. In our case, we're on a 64-bit machine, so we need to go to the WOW 6432 node. Span that down. Go to Microsoft Office. Scroll down here. Expand that out. Office 2010 or Office 14. If you're using a different version, use the right number. And then User Settings. And under here, we should see something that starts with the D for data link, and we don't see that. So we're probably affected by this problem that we didn't install it with the necessary permissions. But let's just double check. Let's go to the other place where we need to see these keys. Let's go to HKEY Current User. Under here, let's expand out Software, and then again, Microsoft and Office. And then here it's Excel and add-ins. We don't see anything listed under there either. So we probably are affected by this. We must not have installed with the necessary permissions. So let's go ahead and get this fixed. You can either completely reinstall or just do a repair. If you do reinstall, make sure that when you install, you right-click and say Run as Administrator. In our case, we already have it installed, so we're just going to go to the Control Panel, Programs and Features, or Uninstall a Program, depending on how you have it listed, and select PI DataLink 2010, hit the Repair button, and you can see it opens up the User Access Control, asking for permissions. All right, now that we've done the repair, let's go ahead and open up Excel and see if our ribbon shows up. And it does. So it looks good. Let's just go into the registry, take another look at what it actually wrote. So again, regedit. We'll take a look at the HKEY local machine first. Again, it's software, WoW 6432 on a 64-bit machine, Microsoft, Office, 14 for 2010. And user settings. And here you see DataLink all users. So it did get installed correctly, so that's why we see the ribbon now. Let's just go ahead and take a look at what you should see on your installation underneath the HKEY local user as well. Under here, again, it was software, Microsoft, Office, and this one is Excel. And add-ins. And here you see the two add-ins listed. So as long as you see those, the ribbon should be showing up and you should be good to go. If all of the troubleshooting steps up to this point have not fixed your PI DataLink ribbon problem, there's additional troubleshooting that we can do. Select the Start menu and right-click on Computer and go to Properties. This will open up the System pane. Select Advanced System Settings, and at the bottom of this window, select Environmental Variables. We're going to be adding a new system variable. That system variable is VSTO_suppressDisplayAlerts. All one word. That's SUPPRESSDISPLAYALERTS. And we'll set that to 0. This will allow us to get additional logging through Excel when an error occurs. Let's open up Excel now and try to enable our add-in. Go to File, Options, Add-ins. Select the COM add-ins from the drop-down menu and hit the Go button. When we try to enable our PI DataLink ribbon, we'll get a much more detailed error. By clicking on the details, we can select this text, include it in an email, and send it to tech support, where an engineer can have a much better chance of solving the problem.